And joining us now is attorney Barbara Smith with St. Louis-based Brian Cave Leighton Paisner.
Yeah, Barbara, by the way, was a law clerk to Justice Samuel Alito Jr. So you've seen all this before. So I'm curious to get some behind-the-scenes stuff here.
Sure.
All the talk right now seems to be about these documents that weren't released, ones that were released but should remain private. Why is this such a big deal with all these records that a lot of people say, well, maybe they should be public?
Well, you know, I think senators are doing everything they can to root through emails that Judge Kavanaugh may have sent or received 12 or 15 years ago when he served as a senior administration official in the George W. Bush White House. But, of course, the question before the committee is what kind of Supreme Court justice would Judge Kavanaugh be? And at least, in my opinion, the best evidence of that is what kind of judge has he been on the Federal Court of Appeals for the last 12 years. And there's a huge body of his own writings and opinions, almost 300. He's weighed in on the First Amendment, religious liberty, presidential powers. If you want to know what kind of justice he would be, I think those kinds of documents might really be more relevant.
Well, we kind of knew that there was going to be a lot of drama behind this just because of the partisan lines and how that line is really, really drawn there. Do you see anything, and the questions today, if you haven't, you know, listened to some of those, go in and listen to some of what's been happening. But do you think any of this is going to affect him as far as getting derailed as far as his confirmation? Do you think that any of this is going to really affect that?
I really don't think so. So Judge Kavanaugh's taken the same approach that all recent Supreme Court nominees have taken, from Justice Alito to Chief Justice Roberts, Justice Sotomayor and Kagan, and even as far back as Justice Ginsburg. And he said that he won't offer any hints or forecasts or previews about how he might rule on potential future cases before the court. So he's limiting his answers to things he's written in the past as a judge, speeches he's given, law review articles he's written. And as long as he continues to draw that line, I think he's relatively safe.
All right, you clerked with Alito, so I'm curious now behind the scenes, right? I'm sure these justices talked about these Senate hearings. These justices, obviously very smart people. Are they doing all this posturing to try and trip them up to make themselves look good? Or what do the judges say about
asking,
all that? It's a mess.
They're asking the same questions over and over and over again in about three or four different ways, like they are trying to trip him up. What is going on?
Well, I think part of it is that senators are, you know, excited to see cameras and microphones, and it's hard for them to sort of, you know, not want to get on TV back home. But they also, you know, do try and press nominees to get them to weigh in and say something that could potentially be disqualifying. And as long as the nominee can sort of sit there and take it, they're generally safe and okay.
So we see what they want us to see, basically. What goes on behind the scenes at these kinds of things?
In preparation for this type of hearing?
Right.
So Judge Kavanaugh talked about this a little bit during the confirmation hearings today. Generally, the nominee will have what they call moot hearings, where prominent local attorneys, former clerks to the judge, senior members of the administration will play the roles of various members of the committee and try and ask the most difficult questions, both so that the judge can practice his own answers and so that he can recognize what types of questions to really stay away from. And frankly, also to just get used to the kind of grilling that he'll have to endure for 12 hours at a time on television. So,
yeah, and now in this case, he's going to get confirmed unless he does something really stupid. There's nothing that stands out that most people are talking about, right, that's going to derail this with the Republicans?
I think that's right. I think he's relatively safe. Republicans have the votes to confirm him. And frankly, at the end of the day, I would be surprised if a couple of moderate Democrats didn't, you know, cross the aisle and vote for his nomination as well, especially the Democrats that are up for re-election this year.
Right. Well, it certainly is entertaining, right, if nothing else.
Not for Judge Kavanaugh.
Oh, yeah,
yeah, exactly.
Productive, maybe not. Entertaining, yes.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
For sure.
Again, Barbara Smith with St. Louis-based Brian Cave Leighton Paisner. Barbara, thank you so much for your expertise. We really appreciate
you
joining us.
Thank you.